Jenkins is a popular CI/CD platform, and as a DevOps engineer, you probably heard of it and you're probably using it from time to time, depending on the organization you're working with. In this video, I'm going to show you how to use a Jenkins playground from the TeKanAid Academy offering. It's a free playground where you can run all your tests without having to build your own Jenkins environment. It's very simple. It's going to use Codespaces. You'll see that in this video. Let's get started. All right, so log in to TeKanAid Academy here, and you will find under the DevOps Playgrounds, you just need to enroll into the DevOps Playgrounds, which is free, by the way. You enroll in it once, and then you're going to find all the different playgrounds here. You got a Docker playground, Kubernetes, Terraform and Vault, Jenkins, and I keep adding more and more playgrounds as we go along. So let's go ahead and click on the Jenkins playground. From here, we can click start to take a look at the instructions. And here is a big black button called opening GitHub Codespaces that you can click on. And that will take you to Codespaces, which is an offering from GitHub. And here you click create Codespace. And again, this is all free. And what this will do is going to spin up a VM in GitHub's environment. And it will have a Visual Studio Code IDE ready for you. And I've programmed this so that it will run a container, a Docker container that has the Jenkins image. And in addition to Jenkins in it, it also has Terraform, Vault, Ansible as well. So you can use this image to run, use Jenkins basically as a CI/CD pipeline, and it can build with Terraform, it can do configuration management with Ansible, it can use, you know, the Vault client to reach out to a Vault server as well. So all that will get created for you. This is a preview of the README file, so you can see here some instructions. This is a TeKanAid Academy playground running Jenkins as in a Docker container. It has Terraform, Vault, and Ansible. Let's make this a bit bigger for you. There we go. And as you can see, it's already pulling the Docker image and it's going to run it for us. Port 8080 is going to be used for the Jenkins UI. We'll see that in just a few minutes. So we simply go to the ports tab right here and we can log in once the container is up and running. To get to the initial admin password, you can run this command. Now, I have attempted to have this command run at the end of the install, so this should print out the actual initial admin password to log in through the UI for Jenkins. Now, if something goes wrong for some reason and you need to recreate the Docker container, you can run this command. And from a persistence perspective, it utilizes volumes, Docker volumes, this Docker volume called Jenkins Home, where you can find where it's going to store the configuration and the Jenkins Jenkins files basically for us. Okay, so if the container fails for any reason, we can rerun it and we'll have all our files intact. Now, this relies on Codespaces, and Codespaces is a really great technology from GitHub that allows us to run a few things in a VM. And as you can see here, this you don't need to know, but you know, just for your own knowledge, don't worry about it, but just so that you understand what's going on under the hood, I have forwarded ports 8080 and 50,000. 8080 is really our UI, so that's what you really are concerned about. Post attach command, which will or is or has already run our bash script called startup script.sh. And I have some extensions here. I've got the HashiCorp Terraform extension for VS Code for us right here as well. And then if you take a look at the startup script, you can see that we're running this Docker run command, which is calling an image that I've created that has Jenkins, Terraform, Vault, and Ansible inside of it. So you can go now and take a look at that by going to the ports tab. And by the way, for some reason, like I said, sometimes it will not print out the password. So you can go ahead and run this command. That will give us the initial password for Jenkins, right? So here's our password. Let's copy that. And we're going to go to the ports tab. And from here, open our Jenkins UI. And you can see we're connecting to this forwarded port, which is forwarded into our container, our Docker container. Here we have our administrator password. We can paste that password we just got. Click continue. And this will just take us to the regular Jenkins screen that you're used to. And you can continue to walk from here, install plugins, do what you need to do to get Jenkins up and running and enabled for your dev use cases. As you can see, this took us less than 5 minutes to have a Jenkins environment get ready to go. And if you're familiar again with Cloud Spaces, you can manage this cloud space from the button at the bottom here called Code Spaces and My Code Spaces. And you can see all the different code spaces that you have running in your GitHub account. So this is my code space. It's using 2 cores and 3.28 gigs of storage in here. So that is it pretty much for this video. We've seen how we can use the Jenkins Playground in TeKanAid Academy to spin up a quick Jenkins environment to run our tests that we need to run and not worry about having to spin this up in a local desktop machine, especially if you're running a Windows machine. Makes it a little bit more challenging because you have to figure out whether you're going to use VirtualBox or WSL2 or what else you need to configure. That's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it, and I will see you in another video.